Welcome students. So today we will have a lecture on rectangular water tank, as you can see the title. So before this, we shall just discuss the design steps and how the design components we have done for the earlier cases. So this is the last design in water tank. In the previous classes, as we can go through, we have designed a circular water tank with flexible base and circular water tank with fixed base. So what was the difference? Was in flexible base we had a bituminous component or tar component below, so that it becomes a bit flexible, and in fixed base it was of concrete. We also seen the design like how we have done for the circular water tank. So in the previous design, that is circular water tank with free top and fixed base and a triangular load. So we decided the dimensions first from the given data. After that, we computed the bending moment, the hoop tension and the shear at the base according to the table number 8, 9 and 10 and 11 in the IS code IS 3370 part 4. And we gave the reinforcement and designed and detailed it. So today we will have a design of rectangular water tank. So what is changing? The shape is changing. Earlier we had a circular water tank, so we found out diameter there. Now here we have four sides because it's a rectangular water tank. So let us see. So this is the numerical considered. A rectangular RC water tank with an open top is required to store 80,000 liters of water. The inside dimension of the tank may be taken as 6 meter by 4 meter. The tank rests on walls on all four sides. Design the side walls of the tank using M20 concrete and grade 1 steel. Now as you can see, this is a design of rectangular water tank RCC. So the capacity of the water tank is 80,000 liters in the given component, 80,000 liters, and the liquid is water. Then inside dimension, they have clearly mentioned inside dimension. So inside dimension is to be taken as 6 meter into 4 meter. That means the wall thickness is not included in it. The space which will be available will be 6 meter by 4 meter. And tank will rest on walls on all the four sides. They are given the grade of concrete and grade of steel. So let us write the given data first. So you can see data capacity. So 80,000 liters is the capacity, holding capacity. So it is converted. So 80 meter cube. Then size of the tank, 6 meter by 4 meter. Free board 15 centimeter assumed. That is 150 mm. You can take anything in between 100 mm to 200 mm or even 300 mm. It's your choice. So we have taken it as 15 centimeter, 150 mm. Just for a change. In the previous cases, it was 200 mm. M20 grade concrete and grade 1 steel. The second step also remains the same, which is the permissible stresses. Now, the permissible stresses, sigma CB is taken as 7 Newton per mm square. And sigma ST is taken as 100 Newton per mm square on faces near to the water surfaces, and sigma ST 125 Newton per mm square on faces away from the water faces. So this is how the permissible stresses are given. So in this you can see in this design the permissible stresses whichever are there. So you can see sigma CP is 7 Newton per mm square, sigma ST 100 Newton per mm square on the faces near the water surfaces, and sigma ST 125 Newton per mm square on faces away from water faces. Now how did we get this? Because this is not given in the question paper or in the question. So let us see. So for this we have to refer IS 456. So let us go to the IS 456. So you can see this is IS 456, which is the plain and reinforced concrete code of practice. Now if you see, just I will scroll down. If you see the permissible stresses in the table of content, I will just show it to you. So just you can check here. So you can see this is the index. So index, just go on searching, you will get the, in the structural design part, you will get the permissible stresses, what are the limitation. So you can see here that permissible stresses is given, which is on page number 80, and permissible stress in concrete is given, and permissible stresses in steel reinforcement is given. So let us go to the page number 80 now. So okay, now you can see this is the permissible stresses, page number 80. So here they have mentioned clearly the permissible stresses according to the codal provision. The permissible stresses for various grades of concrete shall be taken as those given in table number 21 and 23. Now table number 21, let us go to the table number 21. Now this is table number 21, which gives permissible stresses in concrete. Now if you see in the question, in the question our grade is M20 grade concrete and grade 1 steel here. So let us see. So M20 grade concrete, so what is the permissible stresses in compression? So it is 7. So you can see this is under bending, so obviously the walls will be under bending, so we have taken for that. So you can see here we have taken the permissible stress for concrete as 7 newton per mm square. Now let us see this sigma st. So permissible stresses in steel, now let us go down below. So they have already given a table for this also. So permissible stresses in steel reinforcement, as well as they have also given table number 23, wherein you can get the according to the permissible stresses in concrete. So let us see the permissible stresses in steel according to the table number 22. So here you can see, so our is the grade 1, so it is mild shield bar conforming to grade 1 of IS 432. You can see here in the question, so just I will go to the question. So you can see here the grade is grade 1. So for grade 1 steel, you can see this, so ours will be in tension, so up to and including 20 mm depth, so it is up to 140, over 20 mm depth 130. So this is from where we have got. So limitation is up to, means up to it is 130. So what we have done is here, for towards the water face we have taken it as 100 newton per mm square on the faces near the water faces, and sigma st we have taken as 125 on the faces away from the water face. So this is how we have to note down the permissible stresses in steel and permissible stresses in concrete. Okay, now you can see here we have mentioned on faces near the water faces and on faces away from water faces. So what is this? So for this we referred IS 3370 part 2. This is part 4. We have referred part 2 for the design component, and this is for RCC. So in IS 3370 part 2, you will come to know we have to take according to the water faces and according to the water away from the water face. So let us I will just show it to you. This is part 4, so just I will change the code book now. So here you can see, now I have changed the code book. So this is IS 3370 part 2. So this is for liquid water storage and part 2 reinforced concrete structure. Now in this we will go to the design components, and you will come across why we have taken water face and out of water face. So I will just show it to you here. So this is the formula Q upon BJD. So this is given in the clause 3. You can see how to calculate the reinforcement. The design of the member should be done according to this. Also the permissive stress in concrete, here you can see. So here there is a point wherein you can see this is the tensile stresses and grade 1. So you can see here tensile stresses in the member in bending. So you remember we have taken for bending from IS 456, wherein we have decided the 100 towards the water faces and 125 away from the water faces. So here you can see A on liquid retaining faces of the member and on faces away from the liquid for the member for less than 225 mm.
So this is how we have to take. So this is the link you can see here. We have taken it for on the water faces and near the water faces and away from the water faces. So this is according to IS 3370 part 2. So I request you all to go through the code books. So just I will change the code book again to IS 3370 part 4. Okay. So we are with the code book here. So IS 3370 part 4. So let us see in the design. So this is how we compute sigma CP 7 Newton per m square according to IS 456. This also according to IS 456. Now let us compute the other component. So you can see m is model ratio 13.33. So k is equal to m sigma CBC upon m sigma CBC plus sigma ST, which works out to be k as 0.877. Q half of sigma CBC J into K, which works out to be 1.173. So this is remember the water tank is designed according to the working stress method. So these calculations are for grade M20, and as well as you have to substitute here sigma CBC, sigma ST, and we'll get this value. So sigma CBC is 7, and this whatever you want to substitute, you substitute and get the value. So this is K and this is Q. You can substitute 100 also, you can substitute 120 also. Now next is we have to decide the dimensions of the water tank, correct? So in the previous case, which was circular water tank, in that what we used to, we have found out the diameter. Now this is a rectangular water tank and in to in dimension is already given. So let us find out the height of the water tank. So height of the water, which is equal to 80, this is the capacity divided by the area. So 6 into 4, which are in meter, and this is 80 meter cube. So we are working out to be 3.3 meter. So we will round it off to 3.5 meter and free board of 150 mm. So height of the side wall will be 3.5 plus 0.15, which is 3.65. So we will round it off to 3.7 meter. So let us see the L by B ratio, length by breadth. So 6 by 4, which is 1.5, which is less than 2. Hence, the walls are designed as continuous slab subjected to water pressure above H by 4 or 1 meter from bottom, whichever is more. So, the meaning of this is as we have got L by B less than 2, so we are designing it as a continuous slab. If it is greater than 2, we have to design accordingly. And this slab will be subjected to water pressure above H by 4 or 1 meter from bottom, whichever is more. If H by 4 is more than 1 meter, then we will take 1 meter, more than 1 meter. If it is less than 1 meter, we have to take minimum of 1 meter from the bottom. So let us see the further component. So P is equal to omega capital H minus H. Corners are designed for maximum bending moment with this intensity. Correct. This is how it is. So W is the density of water, which is 9.81. So height total is decided just now, which is 3.7 including the free board, 3.7 meter, so total height of the wall, minus 1 from 1 meter below. So this 1 meter below is deducted. So it is 9.81 into 22.7, which is working out to be 26.487 kilonewton per meter square. Now let us see the diagram here. So this is the diagram. So we already know that in to in dimension is 6 meter by 4 meter. The height of the wall is total 3.7 meter, here you can see, and in that small h is 1 meter, okay, and above is 2.7 meter, and omega h is working out to be 10, or you can take 9.81, I have rounded it to 10, 9.81 into 3.7 or 10 into 3.7, so which is working out to be 37 kilonewton per meter square. Now, the next part is to find out the movements in the side wall and other components. So there are two components, long walls and short walls, because they are rectangular. So this we will discuss in the next class. So we have decided the dimension. We have taken the permissive stress in concrete and steel according to IS 456 and IS 3370 part 2, and according to the design tables IS 337 part 4. So we will stop for today. Thank you.